Hi friends, today I am giving a lecture on one example problem on abelian group, order of a group, inverse of each and every element in a group, subgroups, cyclic group. Okay, these are the concepts that we are solved in the given problem. So this is the most important problem. Okay. So this is the given problem. So there are six sub problems are there. Okay. So let G is equal to set of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now on this set G, we are applying the addition modulo 6. Okay. So after applying the addition modulo 6, then we have to check each and every subproblem. Okay, first subproblem, prepare the composition table with respect to the addition modulo 6. For constructing the addition modulo 6 composition table, whatever the elements in the given set, that elements can be written in the row wise and column wise. Okay. So after writing the elements in the given set in row wise and column wise, now we have to fill the composition table. Okay. How to fill the composition table? Okay. I am telling one or two. Okay. So example. So according to that, we have to fill the entire composition table. Okay. For example, here this is 2 and this is 2. So the intersection point is this one. Okay. So row wise 2 and column wise 2, the intersection element is 4. How we are getting? Okay. So here, what is the meaning of this one? So this is a row element and this is column element. Among the two elements, we are applying the addition modulo 6. Okay. So what is 2 addition modulo 2 is equal to? So generally we are performing the addition operation, that is 4. Okay. 4 addition modulo 6. That means 4 modulus operator 6. So what is the remainder we have written? So that is 4. How we are getting 4? So here 6 divides 4. 6 0 0. What is the remainder we are getting? That is 4 we are getting. So this value is here we are writing. Okay. So after performing the addition operation with the corresponding row element and column element, whatever the result we are getting, on that result we are performing the modulus operation 6. Okay. So whatever the remainder we are getting, that remainder we are writing. Okay. So in the same way we are applying another one. So here this one. How we are getting? 0. Okay. So here row element is 3 and column element is 3. So that is 3 addition modulo 6, 3. Okay. So what is the result we are getting? 3 plus 3. That is 6. So 6 modulus operator 6. 6 modulus operator 6 is nothing but, so 6 divides 6. 6, 1, 6. Remainder is 0. So this value we have to reckon. Okay. Next. Another example. 5 plus 5. So 5, 5, row wise 5 and column wise 5, we are getting 4. How we are getting 4? So 5 plus 5 addition modulo 6, 5. So whatever the result we are getting, 5 plus 5, 10, 10 modulus operator 6. So that is equal to 4. So that is 6 divides 10. So 6, 1, 6, remainder is 4. So this 4 value we have to return. Okay. So by using these same examples, according to that, we have to fill the entire composition table matrix. Okay. So this is the first. Prepare the composition table with respect to addition modulo 6. So 5 plus 0, that is 5, 5 modulus operator 6 remainder value 5. Okay. In the same way, 4 plus 4, that is 8. 8 addition modulo 6. 8 modulus operator 6. Remainder is 2. Okay. So, 3 plus 5, 8. 8 modulus operator 6, that is 2. Okay. So, in the same way, we have to fill the entire composition table. Next. After constructing the composition table, first we have to identify the identity element for that group G. Okay. How we are identifying the identity element? Okay. Now we have to check each and every column in the composition table. Whatever the order of elements are there in the given group G, the same order is there in which column? That column number is the identity element for the given group. So here, the elements in the given group G is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Now we have to check each and every column in the composition table. First, we have to observe this column. Okay. Here the order is 5, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here the order is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Both orders are not same. Okay. Now we go for this column. In this column, the order is 4, 5, 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay. Here the given order is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Both orders are not same. Okay. Next, now we are considering this column. In this column, the elements are 3, 4, 5, 0, 1, 2. But here the order is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Both orders are not same. Now observing this column. So in this column the elements are 2, 3, 4, 5, 0, 1 in this order. But the given order is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Both are not in the same order. Now observing this column 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 0. But here the order is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Both are not in the same order. Now observing this column 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here the elements in the given group are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So both are in the same order. So whatever the column number, that is column number is 0. Under the column number 0, the elements in the order 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But the given group G contains the order 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Both are in the same order. So under the column number 0. So now the column number 0 can be treated as the identity element. Okay. Under the column number 0, the elements are in the order 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here, the given elements in the order G are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, both are in the same order under the column number 0. Okay. Now, this column number can be treated as the identity element for the group G. So, now, the identity element for the above composition table is 0. Because so, under the column number, the elements are in the order 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, as same as in the given group G, the order is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Both are in the same order. Now, that column number can be treated as identity element for the given group G. So, here, the identity element for the above composition table is 0. Okay. So now, observe each and every row at which place the identity element is there. Okay. So in this row, the identity element is there. 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 In this row, the identity element is this one. Okay. Now, 0 inverse is. Okay. Here, the identity element is located in this place. So, the inverse of 0 is the corresponding column number. Okay, so inverse of 0 is, okay, so here the identity element is located in this position. Okay, the corresponding column number is the inverse of this row number. So 0 inverse is 0. 0 inverse is 0. Okay, now we are identifying the inverse of 1. Inverse of 1, where the 0 identity element is located? In this place, identity element is located. Okay, the inverse of 1 is the corresponding column number 5. So 1 inverse is 5. Okay, now in the third row, the identity element is located in this place. Okay, the inverse of 2 is the corresponding column number, that is 4. Inverse of 2 is 4. Okay, next one, observing in this row, fourth row, the identity element is located in this position. The inverse of 3 is the corresponding column number, that is also 3. Inverse of 3 is also 3. Okay, next one, for the fifth row, the identity element is located in this position. The inverse of 4 is the corresponding column number, that is 2. So inverse of 4 is 2. Okay, next, in the sixth row, the identity element is located in this position. Inverse of 5 is the corresponding column number 1. Corresponding column number is 1. Okay, for each and every element in the given group G, the inverses exist. 0 inverse is 0. 1 inverse is 5. 2 inverse is 4. 3 inverse is 3. 4 inverse is 2. 5 inverse is 1. For each and every element, the inverse of that element is also exist in the given group G. Okay, now first subproblem is completed and third subproblem is completed. Next, we go for next subproblems. Next, the second subproblem is prove that G is an abelian group. Okay, to prove that the addition modulo 6 for the given group G is abelian group, it must satisfy 5 properties. First one is closure property. Second one is associative property. Third one is identity property. Fourth one is inverse property. Fifth one is commutative property. By satisfying these 5 properties, the addition modulo 6 under the group G is abelian group. Okay, now first one is closure property. So what is closure property? For any two elements a comma b belongs to G, it's okay, then A addition modulo B also belongs to G. Okay, so let us take A is equal to 2, B is equal to 3. Now, so A and B values can be taken from G. So A is equal to 2, B is equal to 3. Okay, now A addition modulo B. So A value 2, B value 3, 2 addition modulo 3. What is the result we are getting? 2 plus 3, 5. 5 modulus operator, 6. Okay, so remainder 5. So 5 belongs to G. So this, the resultant element 5 is also there in G. Okay, so now the given group G satisfies the closure property under addition modulo 6. Okay, now we can take any other two elements. So that is 4 and 5. So let us take A is equal to 4, B is equal to 5. Okay, so A addition modulo 6, B. So that is equal to 4 addition modulo 6, 5. So 4 plus 5, 9, 9, modulus operator 6, that is remainder 3. Okay, 3 is also there in the given group G. So that is 3 belongs to G. Okay, so then the addition modulus 6 operator satisfies the closure property under group G. Okay, next, second one is associative property. For any 3 elements A comma B comma C belongs to G. So A addition modulus 6 B addition modulus 6 C is equal to A addition modulus 6 B addition modulus 6 C. Okay, so let us take A is equal to 2, B is equal to 3, C is equal to 4. Okay, so A addition modulus 6 B, that means 2 addition modulus 6 3 addition modulus 6 C, C value is 4. Whatever the result we are getting, 2 plus 3 5, 5 modulus operator 6, that is 5. So that is 5. Next, modulus operator 6, 4. Okay, so 5 plus 4, that is 9. 9 modulus operator 6. So 9 modulus operator 6 is 6 divides 9, 6, 1, 6. So 3. Remainder 3 we are getting. So 3 we are getting. So left hand side result is 3. Now right hand side result. So here A value is 2, B value is 3, C value is 4. First, 3 modulus operator 6, 4. Okay, 3 addition modulus 6, 4. So whatever the result we are getting, 3 plus 4, 7, 7 modulus operator 6. That is 1 we are getting. So 1 we are getting. Now, 2 addition modulus 6, 1. So that is 2 plus 1. Modulus operator 6. 2 plus 1 is 3. 3 modulus operator 6. So 3 modulus operator 6. So 6 divides 3. 6 0 0. Remainder is 3. So 3 we are getting. Left hand side result is 3. Right hand side result is also 3. That is 2. So now the addition modulo of 6 satisfies the associative property for the given group G. Okay. Next, go for third property, identity property. So in the previous case, in the previous one, we are already solved the identity element for the given composition table is 0. So identity element can be represented by E. E is equal to 0. Okay. Now for any element A belongs to G. Okay. A plus A addition modulus 6 E is equal to E addition modulus 6 A is equal to A. Okay, the element can be added with the identity element. Finally, we are getting the A element. So, let us take A is equal to 2. 2 addition modulus 6 0. So, E is equal to 0. Okay, is equal to 0 addition modulus 6 2. So that is equal to 2. 2 plus 0, that is 2. 2 modulus operator 6. So 6 divides 2. 6 0 0. So remainder is 2. 2 we are getting. Okay. Again, 0 addition modulus 6 2 is equal to 2. That is 2. So now the addition modulus 6 satisfies the identity property for the given group G. Okay, next we go for fourth one, inverse property. Next property is inverse property. So how can you say that addition modulus 6 satisfies the inverse property? Okay, for each and every element in G, there is also exist inverse of each and every element, then it satisfies the inverse property. Okay. Whatever the elements are there in G, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, 0 inverse exists in the group G. 1 inverse also exists in the group G. 2 inverse also exists in the same group G. 4 inverse also exists in the same group G. 5 inverse also exists in the same group G. for each and every element in the group G. Okay, it contains the inverse of that element also. Then the given group G satisfies the inverse property under addition modulo 6. So 0 inverse is equal to 0 inverse is equal to 0. 1 inverse is equal to 5. 2 inverse is equal to 4. 3 inverse is equal to 3. 4 inverse is equal to 2. 5 inverse is equal to 1. Okay. So here the inverse of each and every element in group G is also exists in the same group. Then we can say that it satisfies the inverse property. Okay. Fifth one is commutative property. For any two elements A, B belongs to G, then A addition modulo 6 B is equal to B addition modulo 6 A. Okay. So let us take A is equal to 3, B is equal to 4. 3 addition modulo 6 4 is equal to 4 addition modulo 6 3. Okay. So here 3 plus 4 7, 7 modulus operator 6 is equal to 1. So 7 modulus operator 6, so 6 divides 7. So, remainder is 1. So, this is the 1. Okay. Here, 4 plus 3, 7, 7 modulus operator 6, that is also 1. So, 1 is equal to 1. So, that is true. So, it satisfies the commutative property. Here, A and B values must be taken from G. Okay. So, now, the addition modulo 6 satisfies the closure property, associative property, identity property, inverse property, and commutative property. By satisfying these five properties, now we can say that the addition modulo 6 is an abelian group. Okay. So the second subproblem is solved. Okay. First one is solved, second one is solved. Third problem is also solved. Now we go for subproblem 4.